Hall of Fame. Yeah. And the world's gonna know your name. Yeah. Cause you're better with the brightest flame. Yeah. And the world's gonna know your name. It's pretty cool to be recognized by McMaster, especially that team, because personally, I had so much fun playing on that team. Those are still my friends now. And you know, what we accomplished was pretty special to us. So now for it to be recognized by, you know, McMaster, or, you know, where we spent most of our time, where we all met each other, it's awesome.
This team being inducted really kind of, you know, not that it already hasn't been recognized, but it kind of recognizes, like, you know, that special journey that we made during that season and the feat that we kind of accomplished that hadn't really been done before in McMaster history, right? So I think that was a big thing for the school and a big thing for a lot of the guys on the team.
Great excuse to get them back together. And it's one of the best football teams that I've ever been a part of. And certainly I think for McMaster, it's one of the best teams in any sport that has been on the campus. So excited to see them all.
In football especially, it's really tough to have any success at all without your teammates. So to be inducted as the whole team, I think that's the best way to do it. And just really, really honored to be a small part of it.
One thing I do remember was Steve Ventresca, the night before the Vanier game when we were playing Laval. Our defensive coordinator, Greg Knox, he was like, you know, kind of trying to rally the troops, get everybody all pumped up. And Steve, we were in a hotel conference room, and he was holding one of the glass cups that you like pour water in. And I guess he was getting really fired up or really excited or something. And he was squeezing this glass so hard that, like, near the end of Knox's speech, he shattered it everywhere. Like, just in his hand, literally just squeezing this glass, squeezing it, was getting fired up something. I don't know what it was. But he ended up just breaking this thing in his hand. And we were, like, looking at him. He had, like, cuts on his hand. We're like, man, like, are you going to be able to play? Like, what the hell's going on here? But that's, like, one of the, you know, one of the more PG stories that I can share between everyone.
There was a lot of excitement, and we had kind of been leading up to that game, actually. We had kind of been on the road a couple of times. You know, we had an OUA game, I think it was at Western, that we played the OUA championship, and then we were out east in Moncton to play Acadia. So we had kind of been traveling a lot, and I think that's, like, what made it one of the, you know, one of the special things about it is that you, like, you essentially get to travel with, you know, however many of your closest friends, you know what I mean? You get to do a little cross-country trip around Canada. I think that made that a really fun time, you know, staying in hotels and doing stuff and getting to see places that maybe you would never see before, you know, so.
And then leading up to it, you know, you just heard about Laval. This is the first time we played Laval. We did some preseason stuff with them. Felt pretty confident in the preseason, so I think that helped us that they invited us to their training camp, because we kind of see, like, oh, you know what? These are just regular guys, and we stack up with them. But then you hear about the, you know, the whole Laval thing and how good they are. And they were at the time. And I think that just kind of prepped us that, you know, okay, it's going to be quite the battle. And it was. Right. But I think we were ready for it. I'm not sure why, because, like I said, everybody was trying to figure out how to defer their exams. Maybe Laval was doing the same thing. So maybe it was just, you know, some sort of even playing field at that point. But we were just, like I said, it was one of those things where we went through so many ups and downs in the season that it was almost like, you know what, we're definitely not going to go in here and lay an egg. We're going to go in here. We're going to battle. It's going to be a good game. And it was. And we just kind of came out on top.
Come to the fourth quarter, you know, we're still, we had come back. I think when I scored a touchdown, I think we went up by seven. They drive the field again. Now they're tied. But it was that last drive that was just incredible. I mean, you had some second down plays that, like a pass to Ben O'Connor, a pass to Rob Babick, these incredible throws and catches that we just had no business making. And I think really that, you know, that won us the game, that drive. Even though we drive down, kick a field goal, miss a field goal. And I was actually just talking to Tyler Crepinia recently, and there was some discussion that myself holding the ball, the laces were a little bit left. I think he still, you know, I think I got the ball down. I think it was a good hold. I think he you know, maybe just, I think it was makeable kick. Let's put it that way, but
it didn't go the way that I wanted it to, but knowing that, you know, my team had my back and I had their back. So going into overtime, it was obviously a thriller in double OT, a lot of great plays on both sides. And just kind of at that point, I knew, okay, like this is my chance here. Let's just seal this off. Let's get this done. This is, you know, it's been a roller coaster ride of a game. And you know, that 20-yard field goal at the end of the game, left hash. I mean, that's kind of ingrained in my mind, and I think a lot of my teammates' kind of minds.
I don't know if it was P that showed it. Somebody showed the video of the bridge, and how, you know, the whole one side of the bridge was filled with students, and like it almost seemed like a party. It showed like videos of that, and I remember thinking like, okay, this game ended at, you know, 1 a.m. NBC, and people are over there partying, having a great time, celebrating our kick in the bridge. So that was probably the coolest part, to realize like, holy, this mattered for not only us, but for like kind of McMaster as a whole. You know what I mean? That was cool.
I've been 50 years on this planet. There are only a couple days that you remember almost every single detail, maybe the birth of a child, a wedding, and that football game is definitely one of them. There's not a second that I don't think I remember or haven't relived 1,000 times. Our first national championship. Like I said, on this planet, you're only going to remember a few days at the very end. That is definitely one we'll remember.
We didn't know at the time, but we had so many players that went on to play in the CFL. Matt Sewell, Mike Daly, Spencer Moores, they're still playing. Nick Shorthill, Tyler Crepinia, Kevin Malcolm. All on that team. So we were loaded with talent. We had, in my opinion, the best quarterback in the league. It really is crazy to look back and see how good that team really was.
It's hard to get it into a few sentences about what was, it's so special about it. It's across the board, and it's mostly the people. And we had great people top to bottom.
You know, just stay with the team as long as you possibly can. Don't ever quit, and the experiences that you're going to gain and the relationships you're going to build are going to stay with you for a lifetime.
It's not going to be easy, you know what I mean? Like, you gotta kind of wake up early and go to the gym, and as much as you want to party, it's like the, you know, the play hard, work hard type thing. If you're going to play hard, you got to work just as hard, making sure you're not missing lifts, making sure you're not missing practices, make sure there's no secret sauce to it.
Yeah. Just enjoy the process, because it is a short one, and you know, just enjoy that journey and make sure that you make every second count, and you know, at the end of the day, you won't have any regrets.